What's up, guys? It's Osiris. Welcome to a brand new video in this sampling series. I hope you guys are doing well. Yeah, let's get right into this. So today we'll be taking a look at sampling in the playlist, and we'll be looking into things like BPM matching, chopping our samples, and just arranging our samples in the playlist. Let's get right into this. So let's set our BPM to 90 BPM. Let's try to create a hip hop beat here. And I'm just going to find a loop we can use today. Let's use this. And this loop here is 70 beats per minute, but the tempo of our project is 90 BPM. So we need to make this loop fit with the tempo. So what we need to do is stretch this loop to fit with the tempo. So make sure stretch is on, and we'll set our stretch mode here. So if you want to keep the pitch, you put this to stretch, and if you want to change pitch, you leave it on resample. So once that is set, I'll just zoom in here and try to drag this down to 4 bars, because this is a 4-bar loop. So let's drag this down and just a little more, and this should match our project tempo. Now let's play this. So let's undo everything we've done. So there is another way to do this. FL Studio comes with a automatic stretch feature, so you can just click on the sample here and fit to tempo. Then to ask you for the BPM, if you know the BPM, or if it detects the BPM, then you can just click on the BPM. But if you don't know the BPM, you can first try to detect the BPM. I'll try 50 to 100. Then it detects the BPM and tries to fit that to tempo. So the proper way to do this, if you know the BPM, is to click fit to tempo, then type in the BPM. So I'm just going to type in 70 here and fit this to tempo. So the BPM matches our project tempo. Now let's play this. Yeah, let's flip this loop. Let's play around with this and let's see what we can create out of this. So the first thing I want to do is increase the pitch of this. Let's try this. So this loop is on C sharp minor, and we've just shifted this pitch 2 semitones upward. So now we are on D sharp. So let's try to create on E. So just shift this one more time. So I'm going to chop up this sample, and I'm just going to see if we can rearrange this sample to give us a new melody. So you can select your slice tool and slice up the sample at the transients here, but we're going to use an automatic tool in FL Studio, and this tool is going to automatically chop up this sample for us. So let's select the sample here, then let's go down to chop. Then you see different modes of chopping here, and you can chop in bars, beats, you can chop in different patterns, you can chop complex patterns. Let's try Hitmaker. So I like that. I really like this. Let's close this. You can hear the clicking in that sample. So let's declick this. So I'm just going to select one of these declicking modes. So let's bring in some drums here. Let's go to loop cloud. Let's see if we can bring in any drum loop. I like this one. Let's try this. And this is 70 BPM. So let's fit to tempo. Now type in BPM. Let's type in 70 and fit this to tempo. So let's try to bring in a bass on this track. I'm going to go to loop cloud. Let's select one of our bass loops. So let's try to grab something from this. Let's first fit this to tempo. I'll manually do this time. Let's stretch this and let's just drag this down. Then let's match this bass to the same key as our chord. So this is also on C sharp minor. So I'm just going to shift these three semitones upward. Let's check this out. So let's take the parts of the bass that fits with the keys we have here. So I'll manually cut this up. Let's put this here. Then I'm going to uncheck stretch so we can cut this up. So let's listen to the bass again. So we have, let's put this again. So I'm just trying to put in the bass notes that fit with the keys. So let's see. So we'll just repeat this, then I'll add this up. Let's see. Let's try to add this here. Let's cut this. Let's try this out. We have to fit this to the grid. And I want to put in something to fill up this space. So let's try. Yeah, let's try this. So let's try this at the end and let's put this. So we've created a very interesting beat here. Let's try to add in something to spice this up. Let's add in a vocal loop. And we're using the Jazz Hop Instrumentals. If you want to get these kits, click the link in the description below. And let's put in, let's look for song kits. I'm just going to check another kit for a vocal loop. Let's check this audience pack. Let's try this out. This is 125 beats per minute, but this seems fit to tempo. Let's chop this up. Let's try this. And the key of this is G, so we have to match this to C sharp. Three semitones up is 1, 2, 3. That's E. So G, how do we match G to E? We bring G 1, 2, 3 semitones down. So we have to bring these three semitones down. Let's put this on stretch and bring the pitch three semitones down. We can also pitch this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 semitones up. So let's try that instead. This doesn't seem to be working. Let's try out a different chop. Let's try to feed this to tempo first. 125. Let's try out a different chop. Let's see. Let's try out a different chop. Boom bar. I love this. So we've been able to create a very interesting beat just by taking out loops, stretching the loop, matching the loop to tempo, using a drum loop, chopping up some samples and just matching things to key and to time. So this is the basic things you need to know when you're working in the playlists. Just know how to set your BPM and how to match your loops to the tempo of your project. Know that you can chop up samples manually and you can chop samples up with patterns here. Then know how to match when you change your key, know how to match other samples to that key. So these are the basic things you need to know about when working in the playlist. I'm going to reverse this and let's see how that sounds. Let's reverse this. And that sounds much better. So that'll be all for today, guys. This is how you can sample things up in the playlist and create amazing things with just sampling loops. In the next video, we'll be taking a look at editing and what we can do with editing. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something from this. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. If you have any questions about this, leave them in the comments below. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.